By now, we've beaten 3 human benchmark tests using a Python bot. Sequence memory will by far be the hardest. In this game, you're shown a sequence of squares being pressed in this 3x3 grid. Your goal is to repeat that sequence. For each level you pass, the longer the sequence becomes. Seems like clearing 25 will give us that 99th percentile that we're seeking, but I'm sure we can do better and possibly get the human benchmark world record. Let's get started. So the first thing I did in preparation for this is take a screenshot of the grid and save it to a file called grid.png. As you can see, this is a screenshot. You'll see why we need this shortly when we start writing the code. To start, we import the libraries we will need. These libraries allow us to make clicks, read keyboard input, and view pixels on the screen. The main program will begin when we press the P key on the keyboard. We also need to tell the program where the 3x3 grid is. There are probably other ways to do this, but I find it easiest to take a screenshot of the grid like I just showed you, and then tell the program to look for something that looks like that image. And once the program finds that, it will give me the X and Y coordinates as well as the width and the height of that region. In computer science and in math, this is called a bounding box. And all of this is accomplished by this line right here. Using some simple math, we use the coordinates from the line above to calculate the position of the center of each of the 9 squares in the grid. Now, while the program is running, we need it to observe the sequence. Well, we know that the press square is white, so whenever the middle pixel of a square turns white, we know that it has been pressed. We can tell that a square is white by making sure that all of its RGB values are 255. So we loop through all the squares and check if any of them are white, and if they are, we will add them to the sequence. Let's run a quick test. I want my program to tell me which square we need to press. In the program, these squares are numbered 0 through 8 like so. The square that was just pressed is therefore square number 1. And sure enough, that is what my program outputs. It looks like my Python bot correctly reads the sequence, and now it just needs to repeat it. This part is actually pretty easy. We just loop through each square in the sequence we recorded and click the mouse on that square's coordinates that we calculated earlier. Let's test the whole thing with a 1 second delay between each click. That actually works really well. We could continue like this, but it would take over an hour to get a score 40 at this speed. Let's decrease the delay and make it lightning fast. Oh yeah, that's it. Time for a full run. Unfortunately, when I ran the program fully, it made a mistake at 44, which is still 99.9th percentile, but I knew we could do better. So I made a few more changes to the code. In the record function, I had it wait until the current tile stopped being lit up before searching again. Also, I made the grid detection more robust with a while loop. Lastly, to fix my main issue, I added a delay at the end of this loop here. The problem was that when the bot made its last click of a tile, that tile would turn white, and it would then record that tile in the new sequence because it was still white, and that's because there was not enough time for that tile to go back to its blue color. This delay will fix that, allowing the tile enough time to go from white to blue so that our record function does not register it as part of a new sequence. Now let's do an actual full run. After running it for a while, we easily broke the score of 100. Here, I decided to stop the bot because it has already been running for over an hour and I was just tired of waiting, but it could have kept going indefinitely. This score puts us in the 100th percentile. The reason it shows 64 here is because I had a few unsuccessful trials when I was testing my code, so the average is lower than 100. But here you can see that my last two trials both crossed the 100 threshold before I got bored. The code is available in the video description. It's just 50 lines with a lot of comments, so it's relatively easy to read and understand. If you enjoyed the video, please consider liking it and subscribing to the channel. Thanks for watching.